Guys, Fro the Knight here, bringing you another episode of Third Minecraft Adventure, The Return of the Ender Dragon, and all that crap. Whatever the heck I'm calling the series. Don't really care at this point. I know I haven't made a little video on this series a little while ago. Not really much excuse for it there, except that I was doing a bunch of grinding work off camera. I did some building to the base, so it might seem a little bit taller than last time. Almost done with it. Like, I don't want to make it anything too big. Like I said, just make a little sandcastle, you know? I'm gonna pop a roof on it pretty soon here. I haven't decided what I want to do for a roof. I'll give you guys a grand tour in another episode, though, because there's not really much filling it. It's just a bunch of emptiness. So, like, biggest thing here is I moved my bed. Ta-da. So, go upstairs. Just the lit area, and then another level, which I can't decide would be the last level or an attic or what, but I'll figure it out. But yeah, so nothing much on the home front building thing. Where did I put my right here? I'm gonna have to put like gates on either side of those because I keep dropping down and then doing damage because that is quite a drop. So it's not like dropping from right here. But yeah, so I did some mining off camera to get some diamonds. And the reason I want to get some diamonds is I want to get obsidian. And I have a ridiculous reason for wanting to get obsidian. And okay, we'll need that. But we may have problem. I did not think this through. This is incredibly... Alright, so what I want to do is something I want to call portal hopping. I'll explain that in a minute, but it involves 5 nether portals, which is why I have 50 obsidian. So, let's see. I need flint. And that's what's so awkward. I did all this mining, and I don't have flint. Let me see if I have any gravel in the other chest. If you guys are wondering why I'm walking instead of sprinting, that's mainly because I'm low on food and I want to do this adventure and I don't want to be like sitting doing other stuff while zombies are breaking my doors down or anything. I guess I could place blocks. I don't know. It's not really thinking. I was just thinking I didn't want to just sit around and wait. Oh, I got all these bones this entire time. Okay, I feel embarrassed. I was like, I don't know what I have at this point. I was like, too bad I don't have any bones. Got tons of them right here, which means tons of bone meal, which means I can get lots of bread. Alright, so I'll go ahead. I can go ahead and sprint then. If I didn't trip over myself right there. So we need flint. And flint is like a rare drop when mining gravel, I believe. Not rare, but uncommon. So where the heck can I find some perfect. Alright, so I don't have a shovel for this. Well, I guess I could quickly fix that. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Random crafting table. And we'll just make it out of stone. I know how to make a shovel. Just need one piece of flint. Come on. There we go. 2 pieces. Perfect. More than we needed. Go ahead and eat a piece of mutton. Get off the mutton, because this game likes to do that. I don't know if it's a glitch or what, but there are occasions where... The hell? Sorry about that, guys. My mic started talking to me. Or my headset, rather. It's supposed to stay enabled when I'm talking to it, but for whatever reason it was trying to enable auto shutdown. It's freaking me out, man. I hope that means my mic is recording, though. I mean, if for whatever reason it's not recording. Oh well. I guess we'll find out the hard way. Actually, I'm gonna have to find out right now. Okay, so I don't know what this business with the auto shutdown thing is. It might be just a glitch with the mic or whatever. I mean, it's not like I just booted up my headset and start talking to it immediately, so I don't know. It's supposed to be smarter than that, but you know, whatever. And it's not like it's a big deal to turn off auto shutdown. It's just a press of a single button. But mic is still working. Pause my recording to check. Oh my god, there's a mosquito flying around in my room. That's not cool. So we're all good in the hood. Everything's recording properly, yada yada. And we're gonna get all this wheat grown so we can go into the nether without having to worry about starving to death. I mean, bread is not the most ideal food. It'd probably be better if I found some cows or something, but you know, you do with what you get. So I'll get all this mined out and then harvested. Those are bats. I thought that was a mosquito on my screen, and I realized it didn't stay on my screen when I moved. But wait a second, what are bats doing here? Oh, there's a little dark area here. I did not notice this. Okay, this is interesting. And we got zombies. Okay. Explore this on my own time. I never knew that this cave was here. So, that's interesting. Thank you, bats, for giving me a new possible mining location for resources and stuff. I mean, this coal right off the bat, so that's pretty cool. Yeah, this is some seeds. If I miss some wheat, I don't really care. This is just like more of a temporary farm until I can build a more suitable farm for my needs in the future. So let's just go ahead and make this all into bread. And we should be all set to go into the Nether. All right. First portal is activated. I'm not sure of how I feel about having it this close to home. I mean, on the one hand, I want it to be easy accessible. On the other hand, zombie pigment. But you know what? It's becoming nighttime. I don't really want to sleep again, so let's just go. Right, and actually, while we're waiting for everything to load up, let me go ahead and tell you guys my plan. Here we are. And actually, let me turn on this and then take a snapshot so that way I know exactly where my portal coordinates are in case I get lost. Let's take a quick look around. Do I have I have Optifine for this, right? Why is my oh, there's my zoom. Using the wrong key. Zoom, zoom. Alright. So take a quick look around. Oh, so okay, so there's a good spot over there. Well, that's pretty. I mean, pretty nether considering. Alright, so the plan here is we are going to go, well, I guess I was originally going to try to go both northeast, southwest. I mean, actually, can you even tell here? Oh yeah, facing south, east, north, west. So this is west. Alright, so that was the plan. Like, I'll make four portals, like, probably. Oh, what is the? All right, so the formula with the Nether is like every 8 blocks or something is 1 block in the Nether or something. So like, if I travel and make a portal in the Nether, like 8 blocks, I'll probably get a portal like 10 blocks away, or it'll just link up to my original portal. I don't understand the Nether formula that well. So normally, whenever I make portals, like, in the Nether, I keep them 500 blocks apart, but the goal here is to try to find a unique biome. More specifically, I want to find the ice biome. I want to see some polar bears, man. So I don't know exactly how I'm going to do this because there's just no good way to do it. I just figured I'd just portal hop and see if I get lucky. So we have 4 shots to do this. So let's find a good way. All right. Well, first off, I think we should try to get a good judge on how far we want to go south. So We start at negative one, so we'll go to negative 800 per se. And I'll leave my recording running, but I probably would just skip until I arrive at a good spot. Because I don't want to bore you guys, so we'll just let me do my thing and then we'll see what happens. Alright, here's as good as a place as ever to put down our first portal. Now, granted... shut up, both of y'all. Granted, but the biggest reason I'm saying this is because my original path got freaking detoured several times. I mean, at first, there's this one of those... The thing about the Nether is I'm never prepared for the Nether. I see some of this open terrain like this, and I think I can traverse it. And then, next thing I know, I get into a position where it funnels me into a big mountain like that, and then instead of trying to find a way to go around it, because it takes ages to go around it, I try to go through it. But then I underestimate how thick these things really are. My pickaxe is almost out. So I had to turn back and... Well, basically, I went a huge detour around this mountain, and I'm pretty sure I'm lost now. So we're just going to build a portal. 1, 2, 3. And see where it takes us. And if we're not, and of course, if we're not happy with the result, we'll try again. But at this point, now we're just randomly throwing portals over the place. This is like the fourth... No, actually, I think this is technically the third Nether fortress I've seen during like the last 7 minutes of traveling through the Nether, because I'm freaking lazy to record more. But for something that I've had trouble finding forever in like past Minecraft series or even personal worlds, it's amazed me that I found three of them right off the bat. That's interesting. Alright. Where shall ye take me? I hope it's not nighttime. Ye shall take me into a cave. Oh, what's our biome? Swamp. We are in a swamp. We are underground in a swamp. Very interesting. But alas, that's not what I'm looking for. So, we're going to go through this portal before that skeleton catches up. And hasta la vista. Alright. Is that a new portal? I feel like that's not a new portal sound, but I don't remember ever hearing that when I go through a portal. Oh well. Time for portal number 3. And we will find a good spot for that one soon. Hold the phone, what is that? What is that? What is this? What's it? I swear to God, what is this? I mean, I figured they might have done some changes to the Nether, but what is this? Looking at... Right, this is not... Minecraft magma? Is it mineable? It is. Is it gonna pick up? Oh. It is. I have it? Do I have it? Where is it? Oh, it's right there. It's magma. I'm picking up magma. Does it do anything when I place it down? That's kind of a stupid question, but does it? Does it like, is it like a way to carry lava? Like, if I place it down, does it turn to lava? No. What is this? I'd walk on it, but we're in the Nether. It's not wise to get set on fire in the Nether. I'm intrigued. I'm very much intrigued. I'm gonna grab some of this. And then we're going to do experiments with it back home in another episode. Huh. Magma. Ah, lovely. You're in the way too. I want to go this way and you're right there. I don't want to pick a fight with you Nether creatures. What's next? A new nether mob? Oh, I swear to god, if there's a new type of mod that's mob that spawns in the nether. F you! Return to sender achievement! Alright, come on. Come on. Fire your best shot. Fire. Hit me with your best shot! Don't copyright me, please! Yes! Gotcha! Did you drop a tear? You dropped a tear! Yes! And there's another fortress. Unless that's like a really lengthy extension of that one. Alright. I feel accomplished. We may have not found a snow biome, and we're not gonna quit trying, but I feel accomplished now. We did good. So, 1, 2, 3. There's 3 fortresses. I'm counting that one as part of that. But there's 3 fortresses right next to each other. What the crap? I swear to God, I'm not this lucky. All right, portal number 3. Bring us some sort of luck for a snow biome. I'm feeling lucky. So, let's see if me feeling lucky is actually luck at all. Come on, give me the money. Okay, again. What biome are we on? Deep ocean. I'm underneath the ocean? Wait, what? If I'm underneath the ocean, why is there lava? Oh, that's because there's lava. What level am I at? I am at 12. I'm at diamond level, so I mean, if I found some... If this was like... I'm going to take a quick look at my area, because I mean, if there's diamonds, then... But I highly doubt. Oh, hi, Mr. Eminem. Kind of tempted to set you on fire, but not really in the mood for picking fights. Yep, I don't think there's any diamonds in the immediate area. I'd have to search for them, and we are not searching for diamonds, especially with a pretty broken iron pickaxe. So, but deep ocean. Oh shoot! And he's gonna get here before I can. All right. Alright, settle down, let's talk about this, we talked about it, and we are out of here. That zombie villager is looking pretty menacing right now. I don't know if you guys can see him, but we are out of here. Screw you, you know, I'm not feeling very lucky anymore. Man, that kind of lowered my self-esteem, like, 2 ticks, but, you know, these things happen. Whatever. I am doing probably the stupidest thing anyone in the Nether could do. I hear a ghast in the neighborhood, and I'm making a bridge over a huge pool of lava. Yeah, pretty smart, right? Definitely not gonna die. Alright. Portal number 3? Lost count. Next to all these wonderful looking magma blocks. Okay, that was a heart attack and a half. If you guys don't know, lava flows as fast as water in the Nether. So that could have been extremely, extremely bad. How am I gonna do this? Because I didn't exactly bring my diamond pickaxe. Well, I guess bring this out and then bam. Oh, that would have been, I could have been so screwed there. Again, I don't know if magma blocks burn, so in the event, whatever side I come out of, I want to make sure I land on cobblestone. And that pigment's, those pigmen have been following me? They were all the way over there and they're crossing the bridge. Excuse me, is there a particular reason why you're following me? Yes? No? Okay. Go through the portal then. You guys stay right there. If I come out the portal and you're out to slash my throat, I'm not gonna be a very happy guy. Desert! Wonderful. Heck, might as well just take a quick look around and see what's what. Ugh, I hate these desert zombies. I can't even zoom in on him. What? Shut the up. I feel like I just crossed an ocean. I feel like I just went straight over the ocean that I've and then to another desert. This doesn't make me feel too happy. Oh my god, those zombie sounds. Oh! Oh, the skeleton is out to get me. Yeah. I partially don't want to go back into the Nether because I kind of left in a very nasty area. But I do have a portal. One portal that I could try out. Let me just do a quick look around. I highly doubt that a snow biome is going to spawn around a desert. But, you know. It could happen. It could happen. We'll take a quick look around. See what's what. See if the area is familiar. I highly doubt it because we went a lot blocks away, so maybe kill some of the wildlife because I'm probably never going to be here ever again. That actually sounds like a good idea for food. It's nothing personal, just stay still, it'll be all over quickly. God. This is why I'm a vegetarian in real life. Ooh. 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 What's this? Is this a what I think it is? This is a village. A village made out of acacia. And some other type of block. And of course, like all random villages, for no apparent reason, they always have to have some weird mine going through them. Why not? Why have safe villages, you know? Trade rotten flesh. Why do you want rotten flesh? I mean, whatever floats your boat, dude. Alright, I'm gonna raid this village real quick. And then I guess we'll go in the Nether and try one more time. I mean, this village is pretty cool. Probably wouldn't live here though, because I don't like villages that have weird things in it. Wait just a minute. What is a beetroot? I don't know, but I'm mining it. Oh. Okay, that's very interesting. I thought you guys liked carrots. I mean, if you like those things too, I mean, go for it. And I'm gonna take some carrots and some potatoes for our farm back at home. I guess I can mine all that out, but I don't want to because reasons. Pork chop for an emerald. Not worth it. There's no villagers in my base, so there is absolutely no reason for me to trade with you people for emeralds. No chest in here. Alright, here's the black. Yeah, good luck, dude. I really doubt you can convert a villager. Ooh! Oh, and some obsidian. That's interesting. That kind of makes our day. Actually, I don't need the oak saplings. Why did I grab some of the oak saplings? Alright. We've got some obsidian. That's pretty cool. And actually, I'll need it. I want to make an enchantment table back home. So, if I just used all the obsidian that I had, I wouldn't have been able to make that enchantment table. Alright. Alright. So, going back to base. After I kill these cows. Actually, we're not going back to base. We're going back to try that one last portal. So, alright. I think this is a good spot as any to build our last portal. I ran as far, what direction is this? Biome hell, look facing west. I ran as far west as I could. I backtracked a little bit, so hopefully, well, I guess I could have gone farther, but as far as I was comfortable with. But hopefully that means a different biome, and we don't have to worry. Well, and we won't get stuck in a familiar biome. This biome better be cool, though. Like, seriously, like, I'm guaranteed to be lost at this point. I'm gonna have to check my screenshot, figure out where I am, and go all the way back in between episodes. And oh, hello, another beautiful waterfall. How pretty! And oh, it's more of those magma blocks surrounded by core. Well, no, surrounding core quartz. I can't speak today. But oh man, the experiments we're gonna have with that stuff next episode. Just get excited. I mean, I'm sure most of you guys already know what all that stuff is, but I've not. So you get to watch me make a fool of myself while trying to figure out what that stuff is. So let's get going. Loading terrain. We are. All this freaking running, and we are in the deep ocean. Really? Uh-oh. I may have made a mistake. This is a big ocean. I may have made a mistake. Oh boy. I think I may have made a mistake. Ow. Ow. Ugh. Ugh. Oh, deep ocean next to forest. Yeah, forest is very, very tempting. I was going up in the event that I could explore this forest, though. The thing is, like, I'm going to lose where that portal is. You know what? I'm going to be ending this video. And I still have the coordinates pulled up. I'll figure out where it is. Yeah. And if not, you know, it's not like it's hard not to get back. It's not like it's not that hard. It's not that hard to get back into the Nether. So let's see what's around this forest. See if there's just a small chance that there's a snow biome nearby. And wow, these are big trees. Since when? That's what you get, stupid spider. Since when did oak trees? Actually, I think they did grow this big, but I don't remember seeing them spawn this big. I feel like you've always had to, like, grow one. Like, just get lucky with a sapling or something. So what? When zombies find you, do they, like, raise your arms like, yeah, there you are? Yeah, apparently they do. That's interesting. Let's keep her moving. Oh no, don't tell me it connects to another desert. I'm living in a desert, man. I don't like it. I don't. No. 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 No, I see sand. Oh no, this is just a beach. Okay, well, calm down. Calm down. It's just a beach. That's not an acacia biome, actually. That's a swamp biome. We are not screwed yet. Oh my god, I'm so desperate for a snow biome. I was really hoping I would get lucky. I recognize that these snow biomes aren't common. Like, the only times I've ever spawned one was when I was experimenting with a, what do you call it? Mods. I was experimenting with mods, and I just happened to have luck and spawn into a snow biome. And then I couldn't find, like, it was so difficult to survive in there because, you know, there's just no way to survive with, like, limited resources that a snow biome had. Like, it's kind of like the desert, except cold, you know? It's barren, it's not exactly the best place to grow crops, because your water freezes, as compared to the desert, where you can't find any water whatsoever. So yeah, it's like hard to survive in the snow biome by itself. But other than that, I've never really found a snow biome in the computer version. I think I found one in pocket version, But never when I've ne- whenever I searched, I've had better luck finding a jungle biome than a snow biome. Never found a mushroom biome. I've only heard those things existed. I've never actually seen one. And yeah, we're now like we're doing like oceanic survival now because it's just a beach, which leads to island beaches. And yeah, we're not lucky this episode, so I'm going to try to find my way back next episode. No, I would have found my way back next episode. I'm not going to bring you guys with that stupid long journey of going to over a zombie. So anyway, if you guys do happen to have enjoyed, please leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already. Next episode, we will be exploring those magma blocks. Won't that be interesting? I might have to collect a few more on the way out. But yeah, so I'll see you guys all later. You all have a wonderful day. Goodbye.